Third time's a charm.
Nobody knows that.
Pardon me?
You always give that away. Nobody knows.
Knows what?
That we. This is our third time doing it this morning.
Well, I mean, we have to admit our transitions and
fair enough.
Getting
right.
together. Today is still Friday the 11th
yep.
of October. Good to see you.
Good to see you.
And thanks to Steve, our new audiovisual expert.
Yes, thank you.
For helping us, Steve. And so a couple things. So we met this week with the mayor, Mayor Pro Tem, Nova, city attorney, you and I, to talk about the November city council agenda. Here's just a draft preview of what's happening. That is Tuesday the 5th, obviously. Apparently, we've got a national election or something. So we're trying to keep it light, but we do have city business that we have to take care of.
Yep.
We'll have a real property negotiations on the 4th, Monday the 4th, in the afternoon. And then on Tuesday the 5th, we'll have a potential allocation for the Carmel High School mock trial team, get them to Chicago for their work. We'll have a recommendation from the Rule 20A. This is the undergrounding for the benefit of the public, view sheds, recommendation from the ad hoc committee, which is Mr. Barron and Ms. Dramoff on the agenda, and then theoretically a recommendation from the ad hoc on the flock camera system. And those members are Ms. Dramoff and Mr. Richards. If that's ripe to go, we'll have that on the 5th, Tuesday the 5th as well. And let's see, what else do I have? Next week, you and I are at the League of California Cities, now just called Cal Cities, mm-hmm. their annual conference, which is in Los Angeles or Long Beach or somewhere in Southern California. So we'll be out of the office, bringing back information about what other jurisdictions are doing regarding state mandates regarding housing and the like, fire-fueled load reduction, a whole litany of things. Mm-hmm. It's a good conference. Our colleagues from all over the state, again, and Mayor Pro Tem Richards and Mayor Potter will be with us as well.
That's right.
So it's a good opportunity to not only network professionally, but hear from subject matter experts. In our absence, Paul Tomasi, Chief Tomasi, will be acting city administrator Monday through Wednesday. And then Ashley Wright will be acting city administrator on Thursday and Friday. So
great.
Please call them if you have any issues. Obviously, we're not dropping off the face of the earth, so our cells are still available.
Yeah, we're still working
during the week. So,
yeah.
And I think that's all I had. I think the
okay.
rest is you, buddy. Go
all
ahead,
right.
fire away.
Well, I want to remind people that you were talking about that city council meeting on election day.
Mm-hmm.
If you would like, and we would very much like you to join us after that meeting, directly after, we'll have light refreshments here in the chambers.
Yep.
To watch the election, we'll have it up on the screen and all that stuff. So. We'd love for people to come and be a part of that. It's kind of a little tradition here in town.
The local election.
The local election. Other. Well, we might have the national election up mm-hmm. on the screen. We'll see. TBD. This week, I just want to thank the Planning Commission. We had a long one. We went till almost 10 o'clock at night. We got through 12 items, though, which is pretty impressive for one agenda.
Yeah.
So kudos to the Planning Commission. We want to talk about the Forest and Beach Commission also happened this week.
Yep.
Big topic on the agenda was pickleball, continues to be. There was no official direction, no policy was created, but they're talking it through, they're doing their homework. It was a very civil meeting. Mm-hmm. There's some ideas that are cooking, so stay tuned. I have a feeling they'll come back the very next month. I think they're gonna come back with some more data
right.
and talk about crafting that policy on how to harmonize the use of those courts between pickleball,
you love
tennis,
that word.
And residents. I do love that word because that's really what we should all strive for, honestly, is harmony.
Very, very apropos,
yeah.
Not just for this topic. But yeah, I think that, you know, I think Tom Ford is going to do some sound measurements, get mm-hmm. some data from some of the residents around the courts. And then just to clarify, the city attorney has determined that our code does allow the Forest and Beach Commission to make these kinds of policy decisions.
Yeah.
So, thank you, Forest and Beach, for doing the heavy lifting on that one and other topics.
Yeah. And then sticking with the forest theme, just a nice update from our friends up in Forestry Public Works. There's been 159 trees planted this calendar year. That's pretty good.
Yeah, well done. Well done, Public Works.
And then also 103 stumps removed. That's like a stump, like you think a stump that's, you know, this tall on the ground, that's those. And it's also some of the big tall ones that have had power lines and cable lines in them removed as well. They've been getting some of those out, actually.
Yeah, for decades, some of them.
Yeah, which is really great.
So well done.
That's a big accomplishment. And then the last thing, just to remind people, the homecoming parade, which is a really fun annual thing, Carmel High School homecoming parade, is Friday the 18th. Right. And so we're going to get that green netting back up to help keep all that wonderful landscaping and the medians safe. And then we'll probably leave it up shortly after the pumpkin roll. Halloween parade.
Halloween parade.
That's what I said. Not at all. Thank you for correcting me. I think that's it.
All right. Have a good weekend. Stay warm.
Yeah, you too. And you know what?
Take good care.